everyone, welcome to the Programming Geek. In this video, I am going to show you a basic example of AJAX in PHP. So for this, I am going to use a JQuery library. A JQuery library is basically a JavaScript library used for implement AJAX or to make our HTML page more attractive, or more interactive with the user. So you can download the jQuery library from jQuery.com and click on download jQuery. You can download the jQuery file or you can use the CDN link provided here. You can get the CDN link. I already downloaded the jQuery library, as you can see here. So what we are going to do, we have a table in the database tutorial, user table. It has ID, name, contact number. So what we are going to do, there will be a simple HTML form containing only one text box and one button. When the user enters the username and clicks on submit, so it should show the contact number of that user. If the user does not exist in the database, then it should show not found. So, and it will be done using AJAX, that's without refreshing the page. So here is the table, user, ID, name and contact. So let's start. I have already created two pages, that's index.html and getContact.php. index.html will contain our HTML code and our AJAX code, that is our jQuery code. Okay, first I have linked here our jQuery library file, that is jQuery 3.1.1 min.js. Then in the second script code, it will contain our AJAX code. To get the data from database, call the getContact.php. GetContact.php will contain our PHP code to check whether the user exists. If user exists, it will return the contact number of that user. So let's start. First, I will create some HTML in text box. Input type text, then I will give ID. ID is important here because we identify this HTML element using its ID, so it's important. Then we'll create one button. Input type button and ID will give its ID and name. Submit value will provide get contact. So now to get contact.php will return some data, that is it will return the contact number of user, and if the user does not exist, it will return some string that let's say username does not found. So we should display that response from get contact.php. So we will create here div id, it will name data, then ndiv. You can use here any HTML element, that's h1 tag, paragraph tag or any other. I am using here div tag too, and we will bind that data return from getContact.php, we will bind to this div. So let's start our jQuery code here. First I will create one function that will be anonymous function, it will not contain any name. Then curly brace and provide a semicolon. Inside this function, first we have to get the click event. So for that, dollar inside this double quote hash the ID of the button, that is ID of the button is name, submit. So and that dot click inside this click method, again we define one function then declare one variable where name, this variable will hold the text from the text box and to get the value dollar inside this double quote hash id of the text box, that is name, before id of the text box write hash, then outside the dot, outside this dot well, this will return the text from the text box. So first you want to check whether the text box value is empty or not. So first name, if name is not equal to some blank screen, this will check for some blank screen. Okay, it may also contain some white spaces in front of the string or end of the string. We want to remove that, we don't want that text, so that we will just trim. We will use trim method. So to use trim method, write dollar dot trim. This method will remove any white spaces from the variable name. Inside this, if the name is not empty, then we will just create our post request, dollar dot post. Requires some parameters. First parameter we will give here our target page. Target page is get contact.php, comma. Then we will declare our variables that will be passed to the get contact.php. So we are passing only one variable. We will give its user name colon and data. What data we want to pass? So name contains the username entered in this text box, and this use variable name will be passed to the get contact.php. So then comma, then we'll define another function. This function will contain the response from get contact.php to this page. So function, inside that one variable or parameter data, again here semicolon. So we will bind that data to our div here. Div. So this, our response, this function contains response from getContact.php and data contains response data. So we'll bind here. Again, to bind, we get dollar inside this double quote hash. The id of the div is name data. So name data dot text, we will bind the text, so dot text inside this data. So our HTML and jQuery code, AJAX code is ready. We will write our PHP code here. PHP opening tag. First we will make sure whether the request, post request, is not empty. So to check this, we write if is set, we'll check whether it contains post request or not. Is set, then dollar underscore post square bracket single quote variable name. This will make sure that the post request contains this variable. Is set is equal to true, and we want to also make sure that this, if the request contains name, it should not empty. So we'll check in empty. Inside this dollar, inside dollar again post square bracket again single quote name. If it's not empty, it will return false. So equal to false. Okay, if both conditions are true, then we will create one connection to the database variable connection to hold the connection reference to database, MySQL database. Then MySQL I connect. Connect requires three parameters. First one is your database server name, so local host. Then second parameter is the MySQL username. Default username is root, and third is password. So I don't have any password to my database, so I'll keep it blank. Then select database MySQL I select DB. First parameter is the database connection reference, then database name tutorial. Okay. After selecting connection, connect to the database and selecting the database, we will fetch the data from our request, post request. So again, we will create one variable name, then $_post name. Okay, sorry, we don't want to use the name because we have declared here username, so we have to write username. Name here also username. Okay, as I said, it may contain some white spaces, so we will just use trim it, remove white spaces. In JavaScript we are use $trim, in PHP we just write trim inside this trim. So to make it more secure, user make it secure from SQL injection, to remove that some malicious code passed in the text box, write some SQL queries. User may write some SQL queries. To make it secure, we want to remove that code. So MySQLi, write MySQLi real escape string. It requires two parameters. First one is the connection to the database, is connection, and second parameter is our string that we want to escape it from. So it will get the data from post request, trim it, and then make it secure from SQL injection or malicious code using MySQL real escape string. So after that we will write our SQL query and execute it, and that result will be stored in our variable result using MySQLi underscore query. So here again, first parameter is connection to the database, and then our SQL query. SQL query will be select column name is contact from user, where name is equal to dollar variable name. So we cannot specify directly the user name variable name here. We have to concatenate using dot operator. Again, we have to write some single quote here for one single quote, and then double quote, one double quote. And then here again double quote, two double quotes, then here again single quote in between. So that's make sure you write this for every variable. Again, now this will execute the query and result will be stored in this variable result. So now we want to check whether result contains rows or not. So if it contains rows, we will get fetch the contact number of the user. If it does not contain any row, that means user does not exist. So we'll just write output as not found, name not found. So first we will check whether that result contains any rows. So mysqli fetch, mysqli num rows. Here we have to pass our result. Result is greater than 0. If it's greater than 0, that means it contains rows. So we have to fetch that the contact number of that user. So using mysqli now fetch array, pass it here the result. So now echo, we will print our output, that is contact. If you don't know the basics of how to insert or get the data from database, please watch my previous video here, then come back to this video. It's really simple to get the data or insert the data. So contact, and again dot operator to concatenate row contains our the contact number. So row square bracket single quote column name, that's contact. Outside of this, if does not contain any row, that means user does not exist. So else echo name not found. So first we have checked whether this request is not empty, then we have connected database and fetch the data from post request and write executed our SQL query and check whether it contains rows or not. If it contains rows, then we have fetched the data and echo that is the output, else name not found. So let's check. So here the database contains two entries, that's asking my name, that's Danish, means contact number. So it should return, I'll write here, zoom it. Okay, skill warning. Let's see what's wrong with this. Select contact from user where. Okay, typing mistake. Where? I have just written wrong spelling of where. Here you can see it's telling the contact number of mine. It's not my common contact number. I have typed the name Asim, then should get the contact number of my 1234567890. Okay, now if write something like ABC does not, it does not exist, so it should show name not found. Okay, so if I write Danish, here you can see it's returning and it's done without refreshing the page. So that's the AJAX. So the source code of this tutorial is in the link. I will provide the link in the description below, down the below. So hope you like this video. Please subscribe for more videos and please like, thumbs up, click on thumbs up, and please subscribe for more videos. Thank you for watching.